with ProPresenter 7, there's a layer that you may or may not be familiar with. A lot of people just have ignored it for years. They added it in ProPresenter 4, if memory serves, and that is the props layer. Well, as it turns out, messages also show up on that exact same layer, and they've made a couple of changes in ProPresenter 7 that you might find useful to know about. So here we are in my computer, and the first thing I want to tell you about is over here on the clear side, this is the clear props button. See how it pops up and says clear props, and above it is the clear messages button. They're on the same layer, but we have the ability to clear them individually. When would this be helpful to you? Well, if you had a countdown on the props layer and a message for people to come and get their kid on the messages layer, you could remove the come get your kid message separately from the countdown, or vice versa. Let's say they didn't come get their kid and the countdown came out, then you could remove that, leaving the nursery number there. So that's one example of where that is helpful, and it's helpful to know that that's what's going on. Another thing to know is that we have separate dialogues up here for putting in messages and props. So if I click here, notice that I've got a message that I have from a live training that I did that I could put in here, or I could change another one and put in there, whatever. So that's the messages. And if I go into props, I have all these props that I can put in and do it that way. Now you might be wondering, why would I use a prop? Well, I've already told you about one reason that you would use a prop for putting in a countdown. So I've shown you how to do that in a different tutorial. It's called the three ways to add countdowns in ProPresenter 7 or something similar to that. But let me go into the props editor, which is located here under the more. These four are the ones you're probably going to use the most often, unless you're a business that has House of Worship integration discontinued, then that Bible won't show. But then these are the other ones that you will use less often. So let's go into the props editor right there. So this probably looks very similar to the regular editor to you, and it should, because that's one thing that they standardized in ProPresenter 7 is the editors look pretty similar. They just do different things. So I've got all these props that I've added. If I need to add another prop, this little plus button right by the word props is how I do that. So I'm going to do that. Scroll down to it. It's actually right here because I had the other one selected. Now, first thing I can do is I can change the name to tutorial prop. Okay, so that's thing number one, tutorial prop. And what I want to do is I want to put something on it. Noticing I've got the black and white checkerboard thing showing up, indicating that this is totally transparent. It's like it's not there at all. Like, think of the old school overhead projectors. It's like a fully clean overhead transparency. Nothing on it. So I need to put something on it. What do I want to put on it? Well, I can put anything. So I click this big plus button, and that's where I can put in anything that I want to put on there. So I can put in shapes, I can put in media, you know, just what have you. Let's just say that I want to add text. So let's say Go to our website for more information. And I've got the ability to add in new things there real quick. I've got a text expander on this machine, so that's how I did that. So let's say I wanted to put that in, and I wanted that at the bottom of my screen the entire time for my live stream. So how would I do that? Well, let me first find my mouse. There we go. And I'm going to click on the text box, and I'm going to get this the way that I want it to look. So let's say I wanted to put it here. So I could do that. Now I can go back to the show and put in that prop. So do that, and you'll notice that it is showing up right here. And that's since props are on top of both the slides layer and the announcement layer, that will continue to be up even when other slides are up. Now, of course, I can disable it with looks. I have another tutorial for that, link below. I can just leave it in, just whatever I want to. But that's how I add props. And by the way, that could be a church logo, that could be just about anything. And that's how I add them in ProPresenter 7.